The Taming of the Shrew is one of Shakespeare's best-known comedies. The play is meant as a light-hearted entertainment, and because it is a comedy, it ends happily with a marriage. It is an exploration of the battle of the sexes, and takes a look at what men and women really want, as well as what each of them excels at doing. It may seem that such a story would have no relevance in today's world, but some things change very little over the centuries. And this story still provides a great deal to think about for men and women both. This play is believed to have been written in about 1591. With its comedic slapstick style and simple plot, it quickly became very popular among audiences of the day. It's important to understand where the title comes from. In England, the common shrew is a very small mammal resembling a mouse, and is often found in fields and barns. But the shrew is a strange creature known for its vicious fighting temperament and its constant frantic motion as it searches for food. It will sleep only a couple of hours a day, if that, and only has a lifespan of 1 or 2 years. It will actually die from exhaustion if it goes without food for more than a few hours at a time. Shrew has long been an insulting term for an aggressive, bad-tempered woman, and Shakespeare's audiences would have known right away exactly what he was talking about. The play itself opens with a framing device. That is, it's a story within a story. It seems that a group of noblemen out hunting are playing a trick on a drunken tinker. They tell him that he is really a nobleman and provide entertainment in the form of a play performed by a troupe of traveling performers. The play is called The Taming of the Shrew. In Padua, Italy, a well-to-do merchant named Baptista has 2 attractive daughters of marriageable age. The younger, Bianca, is gentle and sweet, but the older, Katharina, is so ferociously ill-tempered that no man will go near her, much less offer to marry her. Baptista finally states that Bianca may not marry until Katharina does, and that sends Bianca's many suitors on a quest to find a man brave enough to marry her older sister. Before long, a man named Petruchio is found and introduced to Katharina. He actually admires her beauty and spirit and decides to accept the challenge of winning her over. He begins by agreeing with everything she says, no matter how outrageous it is. Strongly encouraged by her father and everyone else she knows, and perhaps seeing a chance to get out of her father's house and have one of her own, Katharina agrees, however reluctantly, to marry Petruchio. After a wedding where he does almost everything he can to keep her waiting and to publicly humiliate her, the marriage is done and Petruchio leaves for home with his resistant bride. Some assume that Petruchio will literally beat his wife into submission and break her will that way. But Petruchio is not a violent man, and he has other methods in mind to bring Katharina around to his way of thinking. Describing this, his method, he states, "This is a way to kill a wife with kindness, and thus I'll curb her mad and headstrong humor. He that knows better how to tame a shrew, now let him speak, 'tis charity to show." Once they reach his home, Petruchio's game is to pretend that nothing there is good enough for his bride, so that she ends up with no comforts at all. Like the actual shrew, Katharina lives life at a relentless pace and never seems to rest. One thing Petruchio does is to deny her food, which echoes the fact that the real shrew has such a high rate of metabolism that it must eat every 2 or 3 hours or it will die. Whenever the servants bring Katharina something to eat, Petruchio insists it is not properly prepared and he throws it across the room. He also keeps her from sleeping. Shrews are very active and restless and sleep little, but like any animal, they must have at least some rest. Petruchio says that the beds and sheets and covers are not fit for Katharina, and they too are all taken away and destroyed. This has the effect of leaving Katharina hungry and unable to sleep, and completely dependent upon her new husband for everything she needs. The one thing he does offer her is companionship, in the form of many sharp and witty exchanges. Katharina learns that Petruchio is the one man she's ever met who is not frightened of her, and she does come to respect him for that. In the famous final scene, Petruchio wins a bet that says his wife, Katharina, is the most agreeable among those gathered for a feast, even winning the bet over her own now-married sister, Bianca, who is not quite as sweet as she was now that she has the husband she wants. To finish the framing story, the nobleman and the players go on their way. They leave the tinker to sleep off his drunkenness and perhaps remember the tale of taming a shrewish wife. The story remains a favorite of 21st century audiences. The Taming of the Shrew is often performed on stage in all venues, from high school to Broadway. The 1967 film version, directed by Franco Zeffirelli and starring Elizabeth Taylor and Richard Burton, remains a lively and colorful introduction to the play. The final conclusion seems to be that perhaps men and women out to work together instead of fighting each other. But that final interpretation of this much-loved play is for every generation to figure out for itself.